the thing we can tag on to the lion tackle is a roll. Okay. Because there are times where I go to get the guy on the ground, but tackling him and squeezing will not be enough. I've got to roll my body. So we've got this little kind of like little stubby sort of dummy thing right there. Okay. And we've got it a little bit off the crash bag. And the reason why is we want the guy to hit as if he was driving for five. So see how he's not spinning yet. And then after a while, the guy's not going down. Now throw him over your body and roll on the ground. Okay. So this is our lion roll tackle. This will be a left shoulder. He still wants to hit with his proper knee forward. I'm driving for five. And whatever happening, the guy's not going to the ground. So I'm going to roll him on top of my body and sling this guy to the ground. Okay. So again, it starts off as a lion tackle, squeeze, drive for five. If the guy doesn't go to the ground, then let's see what it looks like in person. It turns into a roll tackle. So what does that look like? Okay. Bang, ball's thrown right here to the outside. So I am number 29. What is my leverage? I am a right leverage tackle player. Bang, there's a tackle. I'd like him to bring his feet instead of going to the knee. The guy's not going to go to the ground, but see how he squeezes his legs. And by rolling the guy's body over top himself, because of the great wrap and then the roll, the runner goes right to the ground. Here's going to be a good picture. I think this is 55 right here. Okay, on the counter play. So same thing. 32 is trying to get away from him. Okay. Can't get all of my force, right? He's starting to get away. I cannot get all my force. Can't really get my levered shoulder on that thigh, but I can wrap and I can squeeze those knees together. And then me rolling on my back is going to get him on the ground. Here's another example. Here you see in the flat. A lot of times you see these are defensive backs, which is whole key. There's eight, ends up being a right shoulder tackle. But again, what ends up happening, I don't get the thigh. I don't get my pad on the thigh. So those legs are still moving. So now I got to roll on the back and get a chance to get the guy on the ground. Same deal with 17, right? It's a left shoulder tackle. Okay. The guy's a little bit further away from me. I'm trying to run my feet to him. Maybe take one more step, but the thighs are still moving, right? So I've got to wrap up. Okay. And I've got to be able to roll him to the ground right there. And there's some examples here. And again, of our guys here at Penn State of doing it. So they've already seen it. It's something they've already been able to work. So I think this is number two right here, coming out of the safety position right here. Left shoulder tackle, he does. Okay. I like to get this the stronger leveraged knee, but he squeezes the legs and then rolls the runner over top his body. Take a look at this example right here. Okay, here comes the running back. And again, this is going to be number two. Okay, so there's that same position, the near knee. Okay, I don't get the thigh stopped, but I got to squeeze those legs and then roll. See how the roll right there on the body, that violent roll, gives a chance to get that guy on the ground. And these guys, you know, again, times they don't even know how it happens. It's an instinctive type play, okay, but it still ends up happening. Here you see 43, same thing right here. It ends up having to, you know, come off a block late. Okay, I can't stop the progress, so I got to squeeze those legs together and I got to roll on my back to get the guy on the ground.